The business wants to produce for the customer. That is what he means, product design. This is not, you don't have to take notes of this. You won't be asked this in your examination. I want to give you a general idea where we are, because I believe that just coming in and going through slides and just taking care of the slides is not important. As a student, you have the right to know where you are. Where you are exactly, you need to know what is the location. If you don't know your location, you can't reach where you want to reach. So you don't have to take notes of this. Just believe me, just listen to it. And at the end of this, we will know that this is where we are. So product design. Another thing he's taking care of is layout, decisions. What should be done? What should be the layout of the plant? He's helping the other people. Sometimes if the business is small, operation manager is the person who is doing this himself. Mm-hmm. But if the business is big, for example, Wysinco is a very big organization. They are involved into different things. So over there, operation manager will not be doing this. He will be sitting in his room. This is his room, operation manager. He is not coming out of his room all the time. He should, but practically, that is not the practice. He just sits in the room, and people who are working for him, they come with a report and put it on his desk and come in, look at the report. If he finds a lot of variation in the report, then he is inquired, okay, you are head of this thing, you are head of straw manufacturing. Why there is a lot of variation in this? You are head of plate manufacturing. Why there is variation in this process? So only then he would be dealing with this. But if the operation is small, then of course he is the person who is taking care of this. And sometimes he is also involved in location decisions. For example, whatever as a business we are producing, where we want our end products to reach, so they should be closer to the destination. To decrease different costs, transportation costs, other various costs. But this is not what is the scope, but what is the emphasis of today's lecture. But I'm just giving you a picture. Now, one more thing which operation manager is really, really concerned about. His job progress, his benefits depends on that. If he cannot do that, he will be fired. Someone else will come and take over. That thing is quality management. Why it is that important? For example, you want to buy something. If the quality of that product is not good, I'm not going to buy that. So that is critical for operations benefits. What is the name of your course again?
Quality and Policy.
So this is where we are in this course. We want to make sure that the productivity and quality are at par, at the standard. Whatever is required by our customer, we want to make sure that it is at all. And I want you to appreciate this fact that you are not just here to attend the class. Yes. It's not that you just come for the sake of it, just attend the class. Maybe you want to just know what is the question which is coming in the paper. No, that is not what we are really looking for. As a manager, you guys are potential managers. You are doing a degree in business management. If you are not working for someone else, you have your own business. You would be the person who would be taking care of all these things if it is a small business. So now quality is, I think I made it clear that quality is very critical, is very important. So how are we going to make sure that the quality is at par?
Sorry?
That's not really there.
Yes, that's right. Well, I'm going to share my knowledge with you. And of course, you guys can come in and give examples and share your knowledge. So collectively, we are learning from each other. So quality management, there are different ways to make sure that the quality of the business is good, is satisfactory. But nowadays, because the competition is so tight, it's not enough that you are performing at a satisfactory level. You have to be the best. You have to be the best. All right. So, business is a collection of processes. So it is very important to make sure that whatever process is there, it is controlled. If the process is not controlled, what is the point of having a process? You have the best people in the world running your company. You have the best processes in the world. But if they are not managed, not now. Management control of the process is critical. You have to control. For example, when you go out to do groceries, what you do is sometimes, maybe not all of you, might want to make a list. Beautiful. So you say, all right, sugar, salt, milk, bread. Your process is you're going out to the grocery and you select a time, you select a date, you do all those things and you go out. And once you are in the market, you say, so what you are doing is you are controlling the process. What would happen if you don't control it? So what will happen at the end of the month?
Not the money.
You must control your process. even if budget is not the only thing, you know, budget maybe you can afford. Come back home and your helper says, all right, you haven't got him. So you would have to go back to the market. Mm-hmm. You waste time. You waste gas. Everything. So you are controlling process. We are all humans. I want you to appreciate that this is not something which is new. You have been doing it. You just have to know where you have been doing it. So, controlling process, I hope you understand that how important it is that you must control a process. And you can see that what are the limitations if you are unable to control the process, right? Alright. So now one of the ways to control a process is through statistical process control. Alright. So this is, you are here already. You know what is process control. So what is statistical? Oh, you are doing just putting in some statistics and you are controlling the process. Not doing anything. Alright. Just want to use some numbers.
Which one did you make here?
Charts. That's all you
have to do.
You are using statistics to control your process. Whatever process you as a business are involved. You are going to control it using some statistics, some numbers. Now, whatever you want to do, it cannot be 100% all the time. There has to be some way, because last time, 1:30. So some people come in 1:31, some 1:32, some 1:33, some 1:34.
thrown, only 25 minutes short, 6 minutes.
Only by four.
Just different names of charts, graphs. So don't be overwhelmed just by, you know, sometimes when I was studying, I would just by looking at the name, I would say, why am I trying to do this? This is too much for me. But it's not. It's very simple. Alright, so this is variability is inherent process. Like you look at this. A little variation. Here and there. No problem. A little variation is okay.
Sorry.
A little variation. Don't need to worry about that. Don't need to stop your operations. Because if for every little variation you're gonna stop it. How you want to manufacture? It's stopping all the time. So that's why some organization would say, we want some experienced operation manager who has 20 years experience of running the business. Who knows if it's just by looking at the chart, he can say, all right, a little variation, no need to worry about the new person. Say, why, man, what's happening? So now, this is just a name, special, assignable, natural or common. We have already covered it. How? A little variation is common. Beautiful. But if someone is coming 415, but
assignable.
Beautiful. So you are assigning this variation, you are assigning to maybe the person may come late, maybe the person could not get transportation. Some reason. You are assigning, you're just assigning a cause. Yes? Alright. So we want to go back. Look at this. Assignable. So SPC is saying there will be variation. If it is natural, don't worry about it. Beautiful. Yes, ma'am. Provide a statistical signal when assignable causes are present. Give a signal on a chart, on a diagram. It's giving a signal. And as a manager, you won't have to calculate all these things. You won't be calculating these things. Not at all. Someone else is calculating these things for you.
Yes.
Or even yet, you just have a software.
Nice.
Just come out. Look at the chart. You make your move. What to do? So just for exam purposes, it's good to know how to calculate it, and even that is not a problem. Because you would be, my understanding is, you would be provided formulas. Even if you are not easy to remember, just write every formula 10 times. And stays with you.
Alright.
Detect and eliminate assignable causes. Assignable.
Yes.
So this is the cause. We detect it and then eliminate it. How? Maybe we want to make sure that the transportation is there. Maybe we want to give you a call at 11. Yes. Very good. Yes. Alright. Nothing hard. Hard? Natural variation, and just read it and basically have covered it in a way. Alright, this we want to talk about. Central tendency and dispersion from statistics class. Yes?
Yes.
You guys have done some introduction to statistics?
Yes.
You have covered this already?
Yeah.
But never mind.
Okay.
No, nothing to worry about. If you are forgetting, nothing to worry about. Yes.
Alright.
Machine. Long distribution. Yes. Central tendency. What is central tendency basically saying? All it is saying that if this is the mean, this is the central tendency of this distribution. That is all it is saying. Nothing more. Nothing less. You just add on to that, whatever you want to add on. dispersion, what it is saying, how far it is spread from the mean. It can be like this, or it can be like this. That's all it is saying. If someone asks you what is central tendency, just make a bell. This is the mean, this is the central tendency. The more closer the distribution is to the mean, it means the more in control is the process. Let's see how. The example I gave you is the class start time. So class start time is 1:30. One person coming 1:31, 1:29, and so forth. Yes? So if we need to plot this, it will be closer to 1:30. So already saying that the process of coming to class for the students is in control. That's already saying. Someone comes 4:15 and you plot it and the range goes like this. There is a lot of variation in the data. It's not in control. Based on the timing and the time we have set for people to come in class, which is 10-15 minutes on here and there. Either. And come. Mostly people won't come early, but 10-15 minutes late. It's all right. So if this is the case, it's very much dispersed. Very much dispersed. We need to do something. Not made a normal distribution.
distribution to show you the power of centrodynamics. Why this is not normal? Because normal is this.
Yeah.
This is not normal. So let's fix n size is equal to 4, and we're going to create sample size. S1, S2. Give me 4 numbers from this distribution. One by one. What's the first number you want?
1.
1.
5.
Sorry?
5.
Who said 5? 5. Alright. Very good. Who said 5? Now we cannot take 5.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
No problem. You made a mistake. We all make mistakes. We all make mistakes. We are human beings. We're going to make mistakes. And a process is going to make a mistake too.
Yes.
What we want to do is when we see a mistake, we can correct it. So you are learning a business. There is some problem in the process. And you correct it. You are right. So what is the next number you want to take?
3.
What is the next number you want to take?
6.
4.
Or we say 4 and 6. Yeah. So we add them, how much it is?
42.
We're going to divide it by?
4.
What is your answer?
3.2.
I'm going to trust you whatever you say.
3.5.
It doesn't matter what the answer is.
Yeah.
We just want to understand what we are doing. So same way, I'm not going to spend our valuable time on this. Same way you want to do S3, S4, S5, and you can go on to S1 out. This is what you want to remember. The larger the sample size you take, the more accurate the pictures are. You know that already. So now, you have this number and then you have 3.6 and you have whatever numbers you have. You don't worry about that. Now we're going to plot those numbers. So you say, so forth, 3.5, plot 3.5. Whatever number you get, you keep on plotting them. S1, this is S1, this is S2, this is S3, S4, S5, S6, 7, 8, 9, 10, just plot. Just plot. And this is, you experiment, you can go home and do this thing if you want. You don't have to. Because it is already proved. And the proof is called, what it is called? It is called central limit theorem. This is the theorem. Yes. So you plot it. Once you have plotted it, what is the central limit? This is what you must remember. If you write that, whenever someone asks you central limit, you know, tell that under double funding. So what it is saying, no matter what are the samples, once you have plotted enough numbers of the distribution will be normal. On a kindergarten level, we can say that coin, you toss coin one time. Head, tail. There will be a. Okay. There will be a time come where the number of heads will be equal to number of tails. What we are saying, there is equal opportunity of getting head or tail provided. You do it enough times. On a bigger scale, the same thing will be said through central limit theorem. Yes?
Yes.
Alright. Remember this, I might come back to it, but because the space is limited, so I have to. But remember, this is just one thing. Just remember one thing, that the distribution we have, was the margin. Let's remember this. What is this saying now? What is this saying now? This is saying the Mahira process, we take samples and analyze. This is what we did here. Yes? Sample of a product with 5 boxes of cereal from the line machine. What they are doing? This is the line running. Person comes up, picks up one box. And then he did the same thing which we did here. Divided, this time it will be divided by?
4.
Who's at 4?
5.
Who's at 4?
I said 4 the last time.
Last time. Yes, you are smart. I know that. So, 5. Why 5? Because?
5.
So look at this. After enough sample, the picture is kind of this area will be filled. That's all you see. Alright. See? Save that on the next slide. Enough. What is enough now? That you might want to appreciate. What is enough? Can't run away by saying take enough sample then.
Close.
What is enough? Enough depends on the size and scale of your business. A small business might want, on a production line, you have just 20 things coming in. But if you are at Vaisinko, sample size, so what is enough is relative. That's what it should appreciate. Bell shape, this is more, this is center tank. Different shapes, different dispersions, depending on your sample. So as an operation manager, what you're gonna see is this. That's it. On your desk, you come in one morning, open it. You call the person in charge and you ask, what is this? And you don't even have to say, what is this? Because he knows that job, and once he's called, he knows what he will be asked. So, as an operation manager, you want to keep it as close to the center tendency as your equipment allows, as your budget allows. If your equipment is getting worn out and it is not producing the kind of product which your supplier wants, but you don't have budget, what you can do? You can't do nothing. So if your operation manager calls, you say, we need a new machine. It's not my fault. This machine is done now. You need to change it. Alright. So if there is just natural variation, and we have established, I think, that you don't need to worry about natural variation. Natural. A little here and there. So once we have natural, why we don't need to worry? Because in a way we can know that, because past can predict the future to a certain extent, not fully, but to a reasonable extent. So what it is saying is, it is natural, you can accept, you can see, all right, why you would want to predict, to take more orders. My Cinco is already giving orders and a new customer. I go in and I say, all right, I need 100,000 straws. You need to ship them to Trinidad. How fast you can do that? And what is the price you're going to charge
two things, all I want. Because I already know that quality of my single product is at par. So I don't need to check that. If it is a new supply, which I am not familiar of, to figure that out, but for that kind of company, two things I want. Yes? So if they can do that for me, I say all right. If they can't, then I would move to some other place. All right. Look at this now. Very interesting diagram. For 1 minute, don't take notes. Just look at the diagram. And you can take notes later. This is the line which I want as a customer from Wysinko. This is what I want. This is what Wysinko is producing for me. This is the first order. This is my first order. And the align is aligned. No variation. Nothing to worry about. I place next order, and this is the order they supply to me. This is the order Wysinko supplied to me. This is what I want. This is what I want. This is what Wysinko is giving to me. Alright. What Wysinko is giving to me is not aligned with what I want. The most of their shipment is giving me a mean of this, this is what I want. What it is saying, the majority of the products Wysinko is giving to me is of this quality. What I want is what I am going to do. Help them. So I need to ask them that this is what I wanted, which you produced here. It is a bit tricky to understand initially, but it is not. Believe me, it is not. I won't lie to you. I'm going to try to explain it in another way. Same way, but different angle. This is what I want. This is what Wysinko is giving me. I will take the order. This is what I want, but Wysinko is giving me this. This is the variation. If this is the variation, the normal distribution of the Wysinko process will shift here. As you see the shift, you can see what's happening. Now, look at this now. This is their production line. Their production line produced products which gave this normal distribution. But I wanted this. Now, either, if it is produced, either, they have two options, I think. One, just throw away everything. Two, they need to find a person whose requirement is this.
So,
a
person.
Yes.
You're referring to the quality?
Everything. The quality is a part. But once don't look at it only at quality or any particular thing. Look at like you are the person who ordered. Quality is okay, ordered. The mean shifted here, that doesn't mean the quality of the product gone down. Maybe the quality is the same, maybe. The quality is same, it's just it's not producing what I want.
Yeah.
For example,
maybe it was the same time.
Sorry?
Maybe it was the same time tag.
Different reasons. For example, I asked Vaisinko to fill a bottle of can to this level, which is this. This is my requirement. But what they are doing, they are filling the bottle at this level. Nothing is wrong with the product. What's wrong with the product? Nothing. It's not what I want. That is okay. Like you go to buy a shirt, you want to see if it fits you. The other shirt which is not fitting you, not necessarily something wrong with that shirt. It's just it's not your requirement, yes? Thinking is that here, you're just trying to show that the process of Vaisinko is
here and here.
Not aligned to what I want. That's all they are saying. If that is happening as a customer, I would not be sure if I want to order again from Vaisinko because I can't predict. You want to predict, no? Like you are here in class, you want to know your lecturer comes in time or whatever. If sometimes he comes, sometimes he comes 1:30, sometimes 2, sometimes 3, so you are at home, you say, alright, let me not just go.
Not sure. Yes.
So now when we did the example of grocery, we used a checklist. Okay. Checklist is a way to control. Now there are different ways to
control the process.
One way is through, as the name says, control charts. All it is doing is controlling the process on a
chart.
Let's take some examples. What is name one good hotel in Montego Bay? Some top hotel. Which one is good?
Hotel.
Where?
Okay. HS. This is the. This is the hotel. So you are the operation manager of the rooms. You are the operation managers of the rooms. For example, maybe, I don't know, how many rooms in there? Just a number.
50.
Huh?
I said 50.
Just 50?
I think it's 2,300.
That's a good number. Yes, ma'am. So you are operation manager of the rooms. You are managing the operation of the rooms. Different aspects which you as a manager would want to take care of. One of the things you would want to take care of that when the client leaves, how much time it takes for your worker
prepare for the next. As operation manager, you're going to set a time
based on different things. For example, you can look at the industry standards. You can come from all over the world to Jamaica. Top tourist destination in the world. You want to give the best services at all in the world, or wherever you come. Your services, they must trust that they are the best ones. Faster, the better. So as an operation manager, you say, alright, how much time do you want to set to clean the room? 15 minutes. Yes. Very close to the industry standard. 15 minutes means everything. Everything is everything in the wash. So as an operation manager, you have a person who is taking care of the workers. Worker A goes and that worker uses 40 minutes. And your employee, your assistant, for this aspect, there are a lot of things you are doing. This aspect, and as an operation manager, you are not doing those things. You are sitting on your desk. AC is on. Just comfortable and you are having your snacks and phone and all different things. Yes. So your assistant. Employee A took 40, employee B took 30, employee C took 12, employee D took 20. We can expand it, but that is not what I want to get at. And now your employee is going to just join the dots. This. So that this chart come on your table. You are okay, everything is going on for the day, and you look at the chart and you say, what do you want to say?
Why is
this person?
Yes!
No, I need to hire.
Why?
He.
No,
he
just wants to know why.
That's a smart operation. Remember, sign will cause very good.
Yes.
First thing.
Yes.
An operations manager with a lot of experience. Don't just jump up.
Yes.
maybe this is okay, this is okay, everything is okay, but there is a little problem with the bed. So all they want to do is just bring all the employees in a room, and there is a person who knows how to raise the bed. He is like, he has a quality, speciality in that, and he gives a little demonstration of that, and they are okay. They are okay. Yes. So this is what. What happened to this now?
Touch this thing. The keypad.
Oh.
Yeah.
Alright. So you can have an idea of what control chart.
Yeah.
If we ask you in the exam, what is control chart? Just draw your own charts.
And explain.
Explain. Use the example you like.
Yeah.
Don't worry about what is in the book or what. Use your own experiences.
Yeah.
Make example from your house.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever process you are controlling. But remember, you cannot use the example I gave you for grocery shop. Why you cannot use it? Because the topic is statistical process control. That is to control the process, but you might have to do something further. If you are using that example, then you might want to use X bar chart, R chart, E chart, C chart, further to expand on them, on that, and then that example is okay. But if you just stop here, it is a process control, but it is not. Let's leave the natural and assignable. So these are natural.
Yes.
A little here and there, up and down.
Yeah.
That's the difference between natural and assignable. Yes? And what is this? Let's look at this. This is what I want.
Yes.
Yes? This is what I get. A little above. Depending on the criteria I set. Or a little. Yes? Yes. Twice a year. Yes?
This is
the whiteboard.
You know whiteboard? White signal? And the fire says, comment. He's, what he's doing? He's controlling the process of boiling. That's all he's doing. If he's out of that, peach is this. But within the peach, he has set a limit. The cricket board, cricket authorities has set a limit that, okay, your ball can be from this place to this place. Like, for example, in this room, the university has set a limit from, call it, from here to there. So you can come and sit anywhere you want. That's normal. Normal variation. This is normal variation of how you want to sit. But if some of the students come and you open the door, you put the chair there, and say, alright, I want to sit there. Going out of the limit which we have set for the class. So what we're going to do? We're going to ask that. We're not going to just say, oh no man, you can't do that. No. A good operation manager will ask the person, why do you want to sit there?
Or maybe the AC or something.
Many reasons. So if he says AC, then we're going to maybe find a place. Different option. Or he says, yes, some people, we brought in, some children want to make sure they are in his eyes. So, a operation manager says, oh, that's no problem, you can come in and sit here. So, that is, though, even though that is abnormal, not acceptable, not within the bounds of the wicket. But we're going to remove whatever the reason is there. We're going to remove and try to bring that person within the bomb. That's what we want to do. Yes. So first ball, gone here. Umpire says, okay,